That's a plane. I'm sure of that. But I want to find out what else is in the sky these days. So I'm going to go inside to the Mysteries of Space and Sky UFO Conference.
You hear things where the children are saying that they have visitors and people that they talk to in the night. And that can scare you as a parent, can scare you, you know, even if you're talking about an intruder. But typically when the house is locked, there's no evidence of anything, and you have an unusual event like a baby going from one point to another, then you have to dig deeper and see what's going on. There could be many explanations, but when it's repeating in an area, you have to assume something's going on. There's some kind of program going on there.
Wow. And do the babies have any markings or anything?
Some of the children have markings, yeah. A typical, like a scoop mark or a triangle on the leg. And
what would that indicate?
Some kind of test, maybe DNA test or something like that. You know, one of the theories from the cow mutilations was the government is doing the testing to see through the course of 50 years, this is the area where we used to do the atomic tests. So one of the theories is that the government's doing it out with the animals because they're testing blood levels to see how the radiation has dropped over 40, 50 years of atomic testing with the fallout going in the Midwest and that kind of thing. So there's lots of theories out there, but when you really dig into it, it becomes so unusual that sometimes you either... It's like if you don't believe in Santa Claus, and Santa Claus is standing right in front of you, and Santa Claus, you're still going to say, that's not Santa Claus. So if you don't believe in unidentified flying objects being from somewhere other than here, then if one lands in front of you, you might freak out and still not believe it. You know, some people turn around and say, well, there's something here. Other people might go, I'm just not going to believe myself.